The San Francisco Bay Area is ranked number 3 in the nation for energy efficient buildings. That's from the EPA, the Environmental Protection Agency. We follow Los Angeles and Washington, D.C. in energy conservation. ABC7's Don Sanchez reports tonight on what it takes to get a so-called Energy Star designation.
173 Bay Area commercial buildings have earned the annual Energy Star designation. They've been rated by EPA standards against other buildings in the same category.
The things that they need to do are both operational, meaning what kind of heating do they have, what kind of air conditioning, lighting do they have. There's maintenance they can do to make sure everything is working properly.
And this is what the businesses are going for, the Energy Star plaque. It's nothing new for the Hotel Nikko in downtown San Francisco. They've been getting these since 2003.
It's the right thing to do.
General Manager Anna Marie Persuti says the hotel has made a commitment to energy efficiency.
It's good for our culture, and it's good for what it does to the environment and what it doesn't do to the environment.
And it's a matter of attitude. Everyone who works here is involved. Every light bulb has been replaced. In the rooms, there are low-flow toilets and a smart thermostat.
It's a standalone system, so if there's no one in the room, it'll automatically shut off.
And guests are asked to recycle. Their laundry operation is a model of efficiency, from washing to drying.
Brand new machines, we just had them installed last year. They're 25% more efficient than the previous machines we had, saving on electricity and water.
Computer-controlled chillers keep the building at a comfortable temperature.
Being green and doing it the right way can cost you money. In the long run, it saves you money, but the return on that investment can take a while.
Nearly 3,900 buildings nationwide earned the Energy Star. That's a savings of more than $900 million in utility bills. But there is still a long way to go. In San Francisco, Don Sanchez, ABC 7 News.